good evening, and welcome to Reviews with me, Mrs. Bernstein. This store on Church Street caters to the full-figured woman, although I myself am not in this size category. I did go shopping there recently with a friend who has a thyroid problem. The store offered a wide selection. One garment in particular, a floral pastel muumuu, was very becoming and very forgiving. Of course, my friend didn't think it was special, but keep in mind my friend hates any dress in her size. Still, if you are a woman of irregular size and aren't consumed with self-hate like some people, then this store is the place for you. I was confused by this all-male cinema. I thought they might show adventure films, war films, and any other such films in which men are predominantly featured. However, when I entered, I was given a discount because, they said, I was addressed TV. I have been compared to many people in my time. My friends in particular claim I resemble Garbo in her golden years. But I have never been likened to a television set. Anyway, when I got inside, I discovered that this was not a cinema at all. Just a room of booths with television sets inside. The film they showed had no plot whatsoever and was thoroughly disgusting. It's amazing how low entertainment in America has sunk. Also, the acting was very poor. Still, the place was very clean, as the smell of fresh ammonia was in the air. This pharmacy on Lexington Avenue is a delight. It is open 24 hours a day. As anyone of retirement age knows, pharmaceutical needs do not only occur between the hours of 9 and 5. Another plus is, this pharmacy has a restaurant counter where you may sit with friends, have a cup of coffee, and talk about your latest operation or anything else you might wish to discuss while you wait for your prescription to be filled. Because this pharmacy is open late, it is an excellent location for celebrity gazing. One evening when we were there, in walked none other than Mr. Neil Diamond, the singer and entertainer. Mr. Diamond, whom I spoke to while waiting in line, said he was getting a prescription for throat lozenges to soothe his vocal cords. However, my friend said she could tell by the size and color of the pills that he was actually getting a prescription for Valium. He is hoping that Mr. Diamond's career is not in trouble. This car wash on 173rd Street in the Bronx offers the brushless cleaning system, hot wax overcoating, and interior vacuuming. However, After the rent cycle, Harry and I were ordered to get out of our car. We were tied up and blindfolded, and I was gagged with an oily rag. Harry's wallet was taken, and our car was stolen. Suffice it to say, we did not leave a tip. These gas stations should really be more careful about the people they hire. Still, the car was very clean before they stole it. The exterior of this chow mein restaurant on 2nd Avenue reminded me of the days when I was a little girl. My family would go out on Sunday nights to eat chinkies, as we called it then. Our first course at this restaurant was the foo fuck soup, or something like that. I really couldn't understand what the waiter was saying. Anyway, whatever it was very good. However, when I went to the little girl's room, I discovered these on the floor. Glue traps with live mice still in them. Still, the food was fair and affordable, as we did not have to leave a tip. Instead, we gave them a tip. Change your traps more often. The waiter smiled and nodded, but I really don't think he understood what I was saying. And now, for your information, we present a list of phone numbers that we find particularly useful.
So what? Your little TV show's costing me money. Hey, shut up. Drop dead. You wanna drop dead? Drop dead. They're talking up and down.